Hello, cloud gurus! Want SageMaker to be cheaper? Want Athena queries to be more powerful? Want CloudFormation Stacksets to be more maintainable? This week, Amazon gives us all those things. I'm Matthias Anderson, and you're watching AWS This Week. Well, let's start with your wallet. Ever since they first introduced us to it at reInvent 2017, SageMaker has been helping us regular developers take easy advantage of powerful machine learning approaches. Well, now Amazon is continuing their long history of raising prices by... What's that? Oh, right. Amazon is now continuing their long history of reducing prices by dropping the per hour price for lots of different instance families in SageMaker. You really want me to list them all? Okay. They are the ML.T2, T3, M4, M5, M5D, C4, C5, C5D, C5N, R5, R5D, G4, DN, and INF1. Whew! Huh. Prices have dropped as much as 14%. Oh, and if you want to save even more money, you can commit to a certain amount of usage over 1 or 3 years to take advantage of a new SageMaker savings plan. That could save you 64% on your SageMaker usage. But I mean, hey, if you don't like saving money, feel free to ignore all of this, right? Athena is Amazon's serverless query service. They're offering to compete with the likes of Google's BigQuery, and it accepts standard SQL queries from pretty much anywhere you can make them. Now, Athena normally sources its data from S3, but you can also use its federated query support to reach out to places like RDS, DynamoDB, CloudWatch Logs, or any custom data source, really. But this week, Amazon has also made generally available the ability to create and call user-defined functions to transform data. This all happens through Lambda function invocations within the execution of our SQL query. So not only can that offload and parallelize the processing, it can also dramatically simplify the apps doing the querying. There are all sorts of different things that this can enable you to do. You could translate fields on the fly to or from different languages. You could tokenize, encrypt, decrypt, or redact sensitive information. You could analyze text sentiment, whatever, all without requiring you to duplicate or change your source data. Slick. Have you ever tried to manage a series of CloudFormation stacks across multiple regions or accounts? Well, I have, and let me tell you, it can be a real pain in the... Well, it can be a real pain. So I was very happy when they released Stacksets to address this very problem a number of years ago. But managing those template files can still also be a real pain, which is why Amazon gave us macros and transform support too. But until this week, you could not use those macros or transforms in Stacksets. Now that you can, though, you can reuse template snippets by including them instead of copy-pasting them. And you could do even more custom processing through a custom Lambda macro, maybe even one you set up using a serverless application model template. All now possible in Stacksets. Finally, I want to make sure you know that we really value your feedback. Please do leave us a comment below to let us know what you like about our show and what might make it even better. Or reach out to us on our Discord, which we'll link to in the video description. Either way, if you have found this valuable, please give us a thumbs up and consider subscribing so you can more easily keep up to date. Well, all right, stay safe, have a great week, and keep being awesome, cloud gurus!